As you know that the presentation is about Social Security benefits and the planning and navigating the complexities of the Social Security system, you know. Most of us have come from a country where there is no such thing as Social Security, and we do not understand the complex rules involved in this area. So let me take you to the first slide. I cannot read that, but you can read. If you move forward, you can read the slides better, you know, and you can understand these things, you know. The first slide, you know, gives you some basic benefits about the Social Security credits. To qualify for Social Security benefits, you need a certain number of credits. In 1 year, you can earn maximum of 4 credits. You cannot earn more than 4 credits in any 1 year. Social Security retirement benefits are calculated based on the 35 highest earning years. A year without income is counted as zero. I hope this point is clear. You need only $1,220 to earn in 2015 one credit. So multiply that 20 with 4, it means that you need only $4,880 to make 4 credits. In 2014, it was $1,200 per quarter. And in 2013, it was $1,116 per quarter. So you multiply that by 4, and then you have 4 credits. The maximum earning subject to Social Security tax in 2015 is $118,500. So you do not pay any Social Security tax above that amount. And this amount most probably will jump to $128,400 in 2016. But this number is not yet confirmed by the IRS. They will confirm it by the beginning of next year, that what is the cutoff ceiling, you know. To qualify for Social Security retirement benefits, you need 40 credits. In other words, you need to work for 10 years to earn Social Security benefits. To qualify for Social Security disability benefits is something different. You need anywhere from 20 to 40 credits depending on the age at which you become disabled. If you become disabled at a younger age, you don't need 40 credits. But if you become disabled at, 50 plus years of age, I think I will give you the table shortly, then you need 40 credits. For survivor Social Security benefits, that in case a person who has paid the Social Security benefits for 10 years, it is required for the survivor's benefits for your spouse and for your kids, you need to have 40 credits. If you do not have 40 credits, most probably your spouse and your kids will not get any benefits from the Social Security. But survivors of very young workers, those who are younger than 24 years age, this 40 credit rule does not apply. So if you got married at a very young age and you have kids from that marriage and you pass away, you know, at a very young age, then you do not have 40 credits, you know. And also for the disability, the same thing. The workers age between 24 and 31 are covered if the Social Security covered employment consists of 50% of the time, you know, that 50% of the time you were employed in a place where you paid the Social Security benefits, sorry, the tax. The next is when and how to apply for Social Security. You can apply it for Social Security anywhere from age 62 up to age 70. Now, age 62, if you apply, you will get reduced benefit. Why? Because it depends on what is your full retirement age. Some people have 65, some people have 66, some people have 67. So it depends on your date of birth. If you have any question, I can give you that what is your retirement age. But if you retire before you're reaching full retirement age, you can start receiving your benefits at age 62, but these benefits will be reduced. They will be, if you are retiring at age 66, they will be reduced by 25%. To apply for the Social Security benefits, you know, you have to start the process at least 4 months before you want to get your first check. Why? Because it takes normally Social Security to 4 months to process the paperwork. You can apply online at www.ssa.gov, or you can visit your local Social Security office and apply there, or you can call this 1-800 number, which is 1-800-772-1213. And this line is open Monday through Friday from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. Now, the maximum amount of benefits a worker can get is $2,663. That does not include the delayed retirement benefit. You know, the delayed retirement benefit is that if you retire after, you know, let's assume your full retirement age is 66, but you don't want to retire at age 66, then your benefits will keep on going up at a rate of 8% every year. So a person who retires, instead of retiring at age 66, retires at age 70, his benefits will be, because he delayed his benefits for 4 years, so his benefits will go up 30, multiply 8 by 4, 32%. So you will get a check which will be 32% higher. Now sometimes what the next slide is managing the account of your loved ones. Sometimes, you know, we have a relative who is cannot take care of himself. They cannot handle their finances. For ordinary people, we have a power of attorney over here that you can sign that power of attorney and somebody can handle your finances in case you become disabled. But Social Security does not accept the power of attorney. They have their own form, which is called SSA 11BK. So if you have some parents who are receiving Social Security, but they are, you know, cannot handle their finances, you can fill out this form SSA 11BK on their behalf and submit it to the Social Security, and the benefits will start coming to you. You can receive the check on behalf of your parents, relatives, or anybody who cannot handle their own finances. And you have to spend this money for the benefit of that particular person. You cannot embezzle that money. You have to understand that, you know, because this is not your money, it is for that person, you know. So you have to use it for that person's benefit. I hope these points are clear. Now, if a person in the family dies away who was receiving the Social Security benefit, what you need to do? You have to call this number, 1-800-772-1213, and inform the Social Security that the person receiving the Social Security benefit has passed away. The funeral home which handle, you know, the funeral, they can also help you in the process, you know. SS receiver must survive the whole month to earn the benefits. Let's assume somebody died in the middle of September. If they receive the check in September, you have to return that check back. Why? Because person did not survive the whole month. So to live, you have to earn the benefits, you have to live for the whole month. Even if you live for 1 day, you are not entitled for the Social Security, or you live 29 days and you die, the person dies on the 29th day, he is not entitled to the Social Security benefit for that month in which he died. And if you receive the check, you have to give it back to. But if you are having a direct deposit from the Social Security, so when you inform the Social Security, they will reverse the payment automatically. You don't need to do that. So don't write a check to them if you are receiving direct deposit into your account. Why? Because when you inform the Social Security people, they will automatically instruct the bank to reverse the funds. And the funds will go back to the Social Security benefits. Now, any person who dies, Social Security benefits, Social Security Administration pays $255 for the funeral. Lot of people do not claim these $255, though it's a small money, but still it pays towards your funeral expenses, you know. And you have to fill out a form which is called SSA-8 and submit it to the Social Security, and within a few weeks you will receive Social Security benefits, the check of $255. Now, this is the table which shows that how much credit you need to earn if you become disabled, the Social Security benefits. For example, at age 44, you need only 22 credits. At age 60, you need only 38. And age 62, you need 40. So I have very little time left. And the next is there a limit where I can earn if I retire? If you decide to retire anywhere between 62 and reaching the full retirement age, then there is a limit on how much you can earn from your job. So if you are between the age of 62 and the full retirement age, and you make money, you can only earn $15,720 without any penalty. If you earn more than that, every $2 you earn from the job above this limit, you will lose $1 in Social Security benefits. When you pass away or you become disabled or you retire, if you have younger kids, younger than 18, mostly they are also entitled for the Social Security benefits. The child includes the stepchildren, adopted children, all those things, you know. Now, these are the few concepts which are very, very important. That how to increase your Social Security benefits. One way, as I told you earlier, is delay your retirement. If you delay your retirement up to age 70, your benefits will go up by 8% every year. Now, there are other ways to do that. One is disability freeze. It's very important for younger workers that if you become disabled, as I told you earlier, that in a year when you do not have any income is counted at zero. So if a person who is disabled, he will have a lot of zeros, you know, on his Social Security record. So if he applies for the disability freeze, those zeros will be taken out and the average will go up. I hope this point is clear. Second is the backdating. So you can always backdate your application by 6 months. A lot of people do not know, but this backdating can be done only when you reach your full retirement age, not between the age 62 and the full retirement age. Changing your mind. Let's assume you applied and later on you said, I should not have applied. You have 1 year to change your mind. If you receive the benefits from the Social Security Administration for 1 year, you can return all that money back to them. And they will recalculate your benefits from the current date when you return the money. So that way your benefits will go up. Now, there is another way to increase the benefits, which is file and suspend. So you can look on the, or you can ask me the questions if you have anything about, any questions about file and suspend strategy, that how it works, because I have to explain it in detail for you to understand. Filing a restricted application. This is a method which is used by the family where the two people are earning, where you are earning and your wife is also earning. So this way you can, method you can use to increase the benefits. And this method, if you use properly, can make at least $60,000 to $70,000 difference in your Social Security benefits over the lifespan. Now, there are different options available for divorcees, and there are different options available for widows and widowers. So if you have any questions about them, you can ask me the questions later on. Now, these are the helpful websites. You note them, and you can go to these websites and get some more knowledge from these websites. And what happened? Okay, there's no disclaimer. Okay, thank you very much. If you have any questions, please come to the desk after the presentation.